Hello all, welcome to the fourth video of this tutorial series. Today we will talk about setting up an EM simulation in PEPro to run post layout analysis. In the previous videos, we talked about getting started with ADS to simulate power converter circuits and verify the correctness of the circuits. In this video, we will move forward to set up a post layout simulation to analyze the operation of power converter boards. Now, what is post layout simulation? Post layout simulation in Keysight's ADS and PEPro allows the user to analyze various post layout effects that are introduced in the circuit by the layout design. Some examples of these are EMI and EMC compliance problems and parasitic inductance and stray capacitances. Post layout simulation and analysis helps the designer reduce the number of hardware iterations and make the design process cost effective. Let's talk about setting up an EM simulation in ADS. So what an EM simulation basically does is it runs Maxwell's equations on the circuit board we feed to it. The result we get from this is a complete schematic of the circuit that has all the parasitic components and EM artifacts in it. So what do we need to set up an EM simulation? First thing we need is a PCB layout. Next, we need the ODB++ file of that layout to import to ADS. Now, what is an ODB++ file? An ODB++ file is a zipped file obtained from board design softwares that has all the information of the board in an importable format. This includes all the nets, the components, and the layers, and the stackup. The third thing we need to know is the details of the PCB stackup, especially if there is anything to be kept in mind about it. Once we know these three things, we can get started. The first step is to use the ODB++ file to import it to ADS, and it is very simple to do it. We go to Files, Import and Design. Here we select ODB++ as the file format. And import the file to ADS. As we import this file, we have options to select what nets, layers and components we want to import to ADS. Once we know these three things, we can get started. For this design, we will select all the layers and nets and components. However, it is completely possible to skip some of these if we only intend to simulate a part of a bigger circuit board. Once we go through the options and import the board to ADS, it is recommended to check the substrate. Here we will see if the dielectric thickness is correct, if the material is correct, and then we will add a perfectly conducting zero thickness cover at the bottom of the board stackup. Adding this cover is important for PEPro to be able to run EM simulations on the board. While adding the cover, we would also want a thick enough layer of air in between so that the cover does not interfere with any radiation coming off from the board in the EM simulation. Next step is to check if we have everything to be able to run the EM simulation. An important part of this is to check if we have all the components imported to ADS. Here we can see that we see a list of components, however, they only have their footprints in them. To run the EM simulations, we need to have schematics and symbols for each of these components. So we need to add them one by one for every component. To add a schematic or a symbol, right-click on the component folder and add a schematic. Inside the schematic, add the electrical component that we are talking about and add pins to it. Yes, it's that simple. Next, do the same thing for the symbols. and make sure the pin numbers are correct for components like diodes by looking at the footprint and the component datasheet. Once this is done, we need to add pins at the inputs and outputs of the converter. This is done in the layout window as shown. Here for this board, I know where the inputs and outputs are, so I will directly add pins there and move forward. The next step is to run PEPro. As we go into the PEPro window, we need to add analysis to the setup tab. Here I'm adding a parasitic extraction all-nets analysis. For this, we need to add all the components from the project tab to the setup tab. Next, we add all the pins from the project tab to the ports in the setup tab. After this, we go to the setup tab and set up the frequency plan and simulator for our simulation. For this board, I know that the maximum switching frequency is 100 kHz, so I will set up the switching frequency to 100 kHz. The board under simulation here is a two-layer board, and thus we will select Momentum RF as the simulator as it is better suited for planar boards with fewer layers. After setting this up, we are pretty much done, and the next step is only to run the simulation, which we will do in the next video. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.